एंड डॉक्टर भीमराव अंबेडकर।
नमस्ते एसटीटीएस,
नमस्ते।
कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस, टुडे इज अ वेरी पायस डे, द डे ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया केम द एग्जिस्टेंस एंड एज वेल एज द सेम यू ऑल आर टेकिंग रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज टुडे। व्हाट इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन? यू जस्ट सॉ द प्रोग्राम, यू नो अबाउट इट। एनीवन कैन आंसर?
Yes, come. Ma'am, constitution is a document that contains all the rules according to which a country is governed.
Yes. Good.
Anybody else? Yeah. Yes, Rashi.
Anyone, explain it little bit.
A constitution is like an aggregate or kind of document which has all the rules and regulations contained in it according to which a true democratic country is to be governed.
Very good. Very
good. Yes. And as well as the doctrine of
constitution, it gives us knowledge of our fundamental rights and duties. Both, not only right, not
based
only.
Very beautiful. Look, Karnataka based on fundamental rights and duties.
Very. I missed that. Look, Karnataka. But this is the document that explains us what rights as an Indian we have in this country, as well as what are our duties to run this country. We are citizens of this country, and any country is run by its people. As they told it, that a government completed by
constitution and its public.
Government. I said a government
democracy.
Is
democracy.
Chahiye by the people.
Of the people.
So it means any country. What is the country? What is country? Country is not only land, boundary, or other things. It's people. People makes a country anywhere in the world. So you are just like a country yourself. You are representing your country. You are a country. So you always have to remember. What are the rules, regulations? What are your rights? What are your duties? And today, I have chosen this day to give you your duties, your responsibility, like a member of Procurial Board. You have been assigned different duties: literary club, sports captain, or a prefect. What else? You
they are
chief prefects. So duties are also known to you. We feel proud when we get the badge that shows that yes, we got it. What we have to do just to glorify that badge, that is more important than to getting this badge. It's very easy to put it here, but in a real sense, this is glorified when we work, when we act accordingly. If we have been given a, we have been assigned a duty, we have to work accordingly, not only our work, rather we have to encourage others to do that work.
Yes.
This is a combined effort. Always it is a team of Proctorial Board. So we have to work together. I hope students who got badges today, they will understand their complete duties and they will act accordingly, and rest of the students will cooperate them. They will follow them. They will obey their instructions also, because when anyone gets a responsibility, he is your leader. So true leader has to get others' work with him. It does not mean that leader will not work or only others will work. A true leader is that who works and get others involved in that work. So I hope that today team of good leaders has been selected, nominated and assigned duties also, and you all will cooperate them and they will take you all with them to work for the betterment of this session's activities. Thank you very much once again. I just congratulate you all for this day of constitution. This skit was very explanatory in itself. Everything was told. I request all SST teachers and others also, not only SST, every teacher today in every period, just to tell them few lines about our constitution or about all these leaders who were present there to sign over it, and especially Baba Bhim Rao Ambedkar. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank you.
Suprabhat. As per Bhumika Arora, a Prasadhi Vakti Chhatra, aap sabhi ko sal 1949 ki raat ka nakal kar ja rahi thi, jahan par Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar ne देश के संविधान की घोषणा की थी। भारत का संविधान भारत का सर्वोच्च विधान है, जो संविधान सभा द्वारा 26 नवंबर 1949 को पारित हुआ तथा 1950 से प्रभावित हुआ। यह दिन भारत संविधान दिवस के रूप में घोषित किया गया। भारत संविधान सोचने, बनाने और लिखने में सबसे बड़ा हाथ बटाने वाले डॉक्टर भीम राव अम्बेडकर संविधान सभा के आखिरी ऐतिहासिक वक्ता के रूप में खड़े हुए।
Looking back on the work of the Constituent Assembly, it's now been 2 years, 11 months and 17 days since it first met me on the 9th of December 1946. I am glad to find that, with the exception of the Constituent Assembly, the work done by the drafting community I feel so overwhelmed that I cannot find adequate words to express my full gratitude to them. The credit that is given to me does not belong to me. It belongs partly to the Sir Benegal Narsingh Goh, the Chief Constitutional Advisor of the Constituent Assembly. The first chair goes to Mr. S. N. Mukherjee, who is the Chief Draftman of the Constituent Assembly. On 26th of January 1950, India will become a nation. In the sense, India from that day will have a government of the people, for the people, and by the people. On 26th January 1950, we are going to enter a life of contradiction. In the sense, how will we enter a life of equality? In politics, we will have equality, and in social and economic life, we will have inequality. How long shall we continue to deny? How long shall we do live this type of contradiction? We'll do so only by putting our political democracy in the bin. We must remove these contradictions at the earliest moment, or those who suffer from inequality will blow up this political structure built up by this assembly.
It now remains to put the motion moved by Dr. B. R. Ambedkar to vote of the House. The question is that the constitution settled by this assembly be passed.
Yes, sir.
The motion is adopted.
Thank you.
कितना उम्र हो जाती है?
जवाहरलाल नेहरू एस एम मुखर्जी
भारत माता की जय।